Okay, today we're going to learn how to create a boot screen. In just a moment, I'll show you how to create the boot screen, and then later on, I'll show you how to test it. Okay, in order to create the boot screen, we need to open up Paint. We then need to resize, and it has to be in pixels, and we want to change from maintain aspect ratio to not. So the horizontal for the screen is 128 by a vertical of 64. So we're going to click OK. Now we're going to zoom in and we're going to put some text in just for simplicity, maybe a smiley face. So we'll say boot screen. And then let's put some text in here. So let's do this. And in order to save it, let's save it to, let's see, put in tutorials. And we'll call it boot screen. And in a moment, I'll show you how to modify it so that we can actually use it as a boot screen. Okay, we're on the Marlin page to convert the actual boot screen. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the PNG that we created, which is right here, and open that up. Now we have to change it to binary. And down here, we're going to copy it. And we're going to put it in Notepad++. And we're going to paste it right here. And in a moment, I'll show you how to modify the boot screen to be used in Marlin. Okay, we're going to open up Marlin-bugfix-1.1.9. We're then going to open up the Marlin subfolder. We're going to go to examples. And then we're going to open up, let's see, G create. And then G max 1.5 plus. And we're going to copy the boot screen. Then we're going to go back a directory, then another directory, and then one more. And then finally, another directory. And we're going to go in the Marlin directory and we're going to first paste it right here. And now we're going to open it up. And as you can see down below, we have a default boot screen that we're going to change. So we're going to change first the width to 128. And then we have to go back to Notepad for what we copied previously from the conversion. And we're going to highlight this section right here. We're going to copy that. Then we're going to go back to the other. And we're going to paste it after we highlight the section that we're going to replace. And then we're going to save that. And we're going to close out. Next, we're going to go to boards and open that up. And we're going to search on Rumba. And here we have board underscore Rumba. So we're going to copy that. Then we're going to close out. And we're going to press M on the keyboard and open up the Marlin.ino file. Okay, we're going to select the configuration.h tab. We're then going to do a search on show boot screen. So it's show underscore boot screen. And what we have here is the boot screen for the regular boot, but the one that we want is the show custom boot screen. So we're going to remove the comments for this so we can use it. Now down below there's also custom status screen images. So if you were to use this, you'd have to search in your examples file, find it, then go back to the Marlin tool and create your images to use, and then remove the comment. But in this case, we're going to skip that. So the next thing that we want to do is search on motherboard. And what we have here is board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB. And we're going to paste what we copied from the boards file. So it's board underscore Rumba. Next, we got to search on the U8G lib. So that's the graphical library. And what we have here, it says that we need to have it installed, which I haven't really shown you in previous videos, but I'll show you a quick sample of how you would do it. So if you go to Tools, then go to Manage Libraries. And then you type in U8GLib. This is when you're online. And scroll to the bottom. Here is the actual graphical library. So you're going to select the version being the most current, and this will become enabled, and then you can install it via the internet. So currently we don't need to worry about that. So what we're going to do is we're going to enable the RepRap Discount Full Graphics Smart Controller. Currently it's commented, so we're going to remove the comments. Then the next thing that we need to do is go to Tools. We have to make sure that we have a port selected. So we're going to select COM port 7. And that we have the right chipset selected, which in this case is going to be the Mega 2560. So we're good there. So all we have to do is press the upload button, which will compile and then upload our changes to the board. So in a moment, I'll show you how to test it. Okay, now that we have it created, I'm going to show you it actually work. So first thing I'm going to do is remove the USB power. Then I'm going to reconnect it and show you the boot screen. So here comes the boot screen. And then we'll have our Marlin splash screen and then our status screen. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.